Hello friends, I am Bharati from www.learnlikeachildone.blogspot.com. In series of one question daily, or passing question or important question. In this series, today I have taken the theorem, the tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to radius through the point of contact. This theorem I have taken from the topic of circles. Okay, it is a very important question for 3 marks. For sure, either you get this theorem or you will get one more theorem which I am going to deal in next videos. Okay, today we will see how to show the result of the theorem or how to prove the statement of the theorem. Okay, now let me start with the procedure. What I personally suggest you is to please remember 2 words from this statement, so that whenever you see those words in your question, definitely you will come to know that this theorem belongs to that explanation or theorem you have practiced in your classroom. So those 2 words are, one you can take it as a tangent, and one more is radius. Absolutely this theorem is related to the relation between tangent and radius, and everybody knows that tangent is perpendicular to radius and radius is perpendicular to tangent. But it is important that we have to prove it by somehow and show that whatever the relation is there, that is correct. Yes, for that what we will do is, first we will divide the given statement into 2 parts. First part, we use it for drawing the diagram and for data. Okay, already I have drawn a figure, that is I have drawn a circle and one tangent and one radius OP. Okay, let me explain same in the form of data. Whatever we see in the diagram and that we write is called as data of the theorem. Okay, friends, please note that data means it should not be the statements that given exactly in your textbook. You can write it on your own words. The data means the things which you see in the figure. Here I am able to see a circle and a tangent. At the most, a radius you can write. If you leave radius also, it's okay, because in the first half they have not mentioned anything about radius. See, the tangent at any point of the circle, it is half. It means you can draw a circle, draw a tangent. Okay, let me write the same. O is a circle with center. It has a center, its name is O. We have indicated its center by O. O is circle with the center. Then let me give some name to this tangent. Let us denote it by xy. Okay, xy is tangent. Am I right? Yes, xy is tangent, O is a circle. Now after writing the data, we have to write to prove. What we need to prove? We need to prove the radius OP is perpendicular to the tangent XY. Here O is a circle with center and XY is a tangent at P, you can write, because where it is tangent, that we have to mention. Okay, now OP is perpendicular to XY. This is to prove. Next, we'll move to the proof. Before that, we have to make some constructions. Okay, for construction, I'll take one point R on the tangent. Let us denote or mark, take, everything is same. Let us denote a point R on tangent XY and join O R. Whatever you have done here, you have to write it in the form of sentence. It is our construction. We have joined O to R. Now we'll move to next step, proof. Now let us see how the statement can be proved. For that, let us consider this circle. In this circle, we have OP and OQ as radii, and both of these are equal. Why? Because they are radii of same circle. OP is equal to OQ, radii of same circle. Same circle. Now we would consider this line OR. This line OR is having one more point Q on it. It is like a person is moving from city A to city B and he is halting. He halt in the city C, which is in between A and B. Instead of moving directly from city A to city B, he is taking a break at city C. You just suppose that he has got relatives in the city C, therefore he is taking one day break at C, again he moves to B. Okay, like A to C, C to B. If he don't want to halt at C, he would go directly from A to B. In either way, it is possible. Okay. Now, instead of writing A to C, C to B, let me take AB, which is equal to going from A to C plus C to B. In this way, we have to take in this circle. That is, you just imagine a person is moving from O to R. He is taking halt at Q. Okay. OR equals OQ plus QR. OR equals OQ plus QR. Okay. Now, by physical observation, you just see that OQ, the distance of OQ is less than OR. Similarly, distance of QR is also less than OR. Here you can compare A to C, this distance, only this much. Yes, it is less than the whole distance. You can just compare here. Similarly, CB, it is this much. It is also less than the whole distance AP. In this way, our OQ is less than OR. Yes, as OP and OQ are equal because they are radii, I would replace OQ by OP. OP is less than OR. Now, directly I'll move to result. What is that? OP is perpendicular to xy. Let me denote this tangent by xy. Now it is clear. OP is perpendicular to xy. But how? Directly y I have written here OP perpendicular to xy. There is a reason. The reason is this whole story. What is that? Yeah, let me write here. From all the distances, between a point and a line perpendicular is the shortest distance. Is proven statement. And if you draw a line and if you draw few distances from this point P, you just see this is perpendicular and these are simply distances from point P to this line xy. Physically you can see that this perpendicular is smallest. You just compare physically, you can see this distance is smallest. On this basis, we have written here that from all the distances between a point and a line, perpendicular is the smallest and OP is smallest, therefore that is perpendicular. The statement is proved. Here, one small incident I want to share with you. There was a competition. Teacher called two students, told them to eat their food from the plate without using their hands. Students were surprised, how to eat without our hands? But out of two guys, one was very smart. He told other one, you just sit in front of me and take your hands, use your hands, you just feed me. Yes. And now it is his turn, that other boy's turn. He also used his hands and fed the boy in front of him. In this way, both the boys had their food. The teacher was surprised and gave them a prize. Why I am telling this story means this whole theorem is like that only. Whatever we need to tell directly, that OP is shortest distance because it is perpendicular. It is perpendicular because it is shortest. Instead of telling these two statements, we are just telling the and revolving the whole story around a small point. So is the logic. You don't tell OP is perpendicular to XY and narrate the story in this way. So don't take this theorem very seriously. It is very easy theorem and just like this fun story, it is also interesting. Just take OP and OQ as radii and take OR. OR is the longest distance, OQ is the shortest distance, and replace OQ by OP, then directly you can write OP is the perpendicular line for XY, that is OP is perpendicular to XY. In this way you can prove this theorem in fun manner. Okay friends, if you like this explanation, you just give thumbs up, share with your friends, and please do subscribe my channel so that I can send you my notifications. Thank you.